get out of his car. He's on the end there. The
oh, I see him there.
Oh, he did get out.
Folks to gather around. Come on up. We do have some seats up.
Yeah, like I said, if you come in the same car, there's not much point in keeping you 6 feet apart. But if you're not in the same car, we're going to move them up.
Well, welcome, everyone. Thank you for coming today to celebrate the life and memory of our dear brother, father, cousin, relative, everyone who has come for our brother. My brother, Derwin Vilandre. So would you open with me with a word of prayer? May I have you bow your heads, please? Lord Jesus, we thank you for the life that we are about to celebrate and the memories that we are going to share together today of an extraordinary person, God, who lived a life of purpose and a life that meant something to so many. Father, we thank you now that as we come together to celebrate his life on earth and also his eternal homecoming, God, we thank you for Derwin, Lord, and we thank you that everyone was brought here safely. And God, we just ask that your hand of protection would be over all of us, God, during this season of life, and protect us all, God, from any illness. Bring us safely back home, God. Thank you, everyone who made it here today to celebrate Derwin's life. And so, Lord Jesus, we ask you that your Holy Spirit would come and that you would fill this place, God, fill our hearts fresh. Lord, we welcome you to speak to our hearts today, that you would be the God of comfort, that you would be the God of peace, God, and that you would meet each one of us at the very point of our need. So, Lord Jesus, we say, come. And, Lord, would you direct our celebration of life for Derwin Vilandre? It's in the name of Christ that we pray. Amen. We're going to open up with a very familiar song, Amazing Grace. And I think you should have a copy of the words in your bulletin. So if you guys want to stand with us.
Amazing Grace.
precious gift that grace appear. The hour I first believed.
Through many dangers.
Through many dangers, toils and snares,
bridge, dear ones, oh so happy and so bright, there's a perfect joy and beauty in this everlasting light. All the pain and grief is over, every restless tossing past. I am now forever safe at Rainbow Bridge at last. My broken body's home now, every sickness healed and more. I see you walk in rest now, just beyond the rainbow's door. And you must not be so sorry, for I watch you every day. Try to look beyond earth's shadows, you will see me run and play. When your work is all completed, look up just beyond that ridge. I'm waiting for our meeting at the Stories Rainbow Ridge. We love you, Derwin.
Our next thing that we're going to sing at this time is How Great Thou Art.
Oh Lord my God, when consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think of God his Son, not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. when Christ shall come. With shouts of acclamation, and lead me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall bow with humble adoration, and then proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul.
Tracy, can I have you come up?
Remembering the life of Derwin Richard, oldest of 11 children of Richard and Donna Romdovic Vilandre, was born on April 29, 1954 in Havre, Montana. At a very young age, the family moved to Prairie, North Dakota. Derwin attended Prairie Public School and graduated from Devils Lake High School with the class of 1972. He continued his education at the Lake Region Junior College, receiving his certification in carpentry and woodworking. Derwin married Kathy Labor, and they established their home in Minot, North Dakota. Derwin worked as a custom cabinet maker and also used his carpentry skills in new builds and remodeling. In 1980, Derwin was severely injured in a motor vehicle accident, and his life was forever changed. For the past 20 years, Derwin had made his home in Devil's Lake, where he had lived, where he had the loving support of his family and friends through the years. In high school, Derwin was a three-star athlete. He excelled in basketball, football, and track. He loved the outdoors, fishing, and hunting with family and friends. Derwin was always a jokester at heart. Despite all of the challenges he faced, he always took the time to laugh, to smile, and tried to never leave the room or conversation without sharing that laughter and making you smile too. Derwin was passionate about his faith. He knew the promises of the Lord and the Savior and shared that with everyone. He loved his Lord, his family, his friends, and all those who cared for him through the years. Derwin's loving family include his son Jesse, Danielle Vilandre Hauser of Minot, North Dakota, grandsons Derwin and Davin, brothers and sisters Ben Pat Vilandre, Deb Levin of all of Devil's Lake, Shelley Todd Lavender, Minnewaukan, North Dakota, Rob Vilandre, West Fargo, Mary, Darcy Martin, Jim Vilandre of Devil's Lake and of Fargo, North Dakota, and Brian Vilandre, also West Fargo. Precious aunts, uncles, cousins, nieces, and nephews also survive. He was preceded in death by his parents, stepdad Jack Vilandre, sisters Gail Vilandre and Shirley Olivas, brother Gordon Vilandre, and niece Nicole Olivas Ramirez.
Thanks, Tracy. At this time, we're going to open up the microphone if anybody wants to come up and share maybe a fond memory of Derwin or something funny, because Derwin's got a lot of things that he made us laugh about, so I'll give you just a couple minutes. I'll start, okay, good idea. Well, we all know that Derwin was the ultimate jokester, and he had his own language, we all know this. He called it Derwinese, and many of us have become well-skilled in Derwinese. It involves being able to get our spelling skills up to snuff. Another thing that we used to say about Derwin, we called him the Big D. And another thing that I thought was really fun, Derwin always liked to experiment with different things that he would eat and taste. And one of them which I think should probably become a, you know, a big smash hit, is cough tea. You take some tea and some coffee and you mix those together, throw in some honey, and there you have it, cough tea. I could see Nesty coming up with tabling that one. One other thing that always made me laugh, Derwin had this table prayer that he would say, and you guys probably remember this. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let me read that again. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, the one that eats the fastest gets the most. Another thing we used to call him was Wonder. Since he was the number one son, we called him Wonder. Derwin, the number one son. And my sister Shelley, I'm going to speak on her behalf because she loves to public speak, but just not at this time. No, she doesn't. She's shaking her head. We were recalling a time when Shelley used to go and get Derwin at the home, and she'd be pushing him down the bike path, and Derwin would say to her, "So whenever we get close to Mom's, let me know, Shell," because of course Derwin is blind, so he couldn't see. But then Shelley would tell him within a block or so of the place and say, "Okay, Derwin, we're getting close to Mom's," and then Derwin would start yelling, "Mom! Mom!" And then Shelley would start to get embarrassed because people would think that she was somehow harming him or something, pushing him down the sidewalk. So that was Derwin's fun way of letting us laugh. He just had such an incredible sense of humor. When Derwin would finish drinking his beverage, he would say, "I downed her." Everything has a D in it, downed her, wonder. And he was just always the jokester. I remember one of his favorite jokes that he liked to say was, "You kiss your honey, the nose is runny. You think it's funny, but it's snot." That was probably one of my favorites. He used to make us laugh. I always had such fond memories of Derwin when we would go up to Minot to visit. In fact, one time I remember his dog Haiti, which he loved black labs, had pups, and I think they had like 12 if I'm not mistaken, and those things were running all over. But I remember how Derwin would train Haiti he'd put a piece of food on Haiti's nose and then tell him to wait, and then when ready on command, then Haiti would flip the food up into her mouth. I thought that was really cool. Is anybody else, anything coming to mind? Anybody want to share anything? Okay, come on up, man.
As far as I'm concerned, family doesn't have any terms. This is hard. Anyway, I have many fond memories of Derwin. One of them is to go to the food combinations. I just about couldn't handle it one day at the home. I was feeding him, and he wanted prune juice and milk mixed together. And I always thought prune juice was purple because I've never drinking it before, but it's brown. It's really gross. And then if he'd ever have a sandwich, he'd always say, "Step on it," to smash it down. I have a couple things that come to mind. One time, he was staying with us overnight at our house, and I had never fully gotten Derwin ready for the day yet, but I thought I just had it down, and Gordy had to go to work. So we got to his socks, and that's where we sat. I could no more get his socks on than, I mean, I tried everything. I was like, "Derwin, am I hurting you?" I know I was pinching his legs. I was trying with everything I had, trying to get these socks on, and he finally said, "Get some baby powder." So I went and got some baby powder, and I don't know if it was a big thing of baby powder, and it had been in the cupboard for a long time. And so I was just getting ready to do it, and it was plugged. And so He's laying on the bed. He's got his feet up on a pillow and his underwear on. And I went to open it, and the thing exploded. And so we were both covered in powder, choking and laughing. And, you know, I mean, we laughed so hard. I had to sit down on the bedroom floor because I was laughing so hard. And then I didn't know how to clean him off, so I got the dustbuster. And I was doing the bed and whatever. He's like, just go over me too. And then we had to wash his, he had powder up his nose, in his mouth, in his ears. I was covered. That was quite the deal. And then another time, I remember it was in the spring, probably a little sooner than this time of year, but we were walking with him in his wheelchair, and we went by Gate City Bank. And I said, Derwin, you should see the icicles on Gate City Bank. It's melting, and they're, like, huge. And he's like, I want one. And I said, what do you mean? He goes, do you know how long it's been since I sucked on an icicle? And so we're standing there, so I went and broke him off one and gave it to him in his hands, and he was sucking away like it was the best popsicle in the world. And he goes, what's wrong with you? Get one for yourself. So here we were sitting in the main traffic or whatever, and we're both sucking on icicles in front of Gate City Bank. So those are the memories, a couple I had.
That's awesome. Anybody else want to share a story? Fond memory? In the book of John, I'm going to read this because I think this is very applicable to Derwin, because Derwin really believed this with all his heart. And so I need to share this. This is from John 3:16-17. It says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. And Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life, and no one comes to the Father except through me. The life and times of Derwin Vilandre. Born on April 29th, in fact, just a couple days away, Derwin would have turned 56 years old. 1954, he was born to Richard and Donna Vilandre. He was an active, full of life, involved in sports, playing basketball, track, and football. And yet, Derwin was no stranger to loss and or to pain. At the age of 12 years old, Derwin's father was killed in an unfortunate accident, leaving him with the pain of this tremendous loss of his father, Richard. Derwin excelled at sports, and he even had some college recruiters eyeing him as a possible recruit. As a young man, Derwin loved the outdoors. He loved to hunt and fish. He had an affinity to black labs with one of his prize dogs named Haiti. Derwin attended Lake Region State College for carpentry, and then shortly after getting married to Kathy, moved to Minot, North Dakota to work as a skilled carpenter, specializing in making cabinets. At the age of 25, Derwin was involved in a life-changing accident that altered his life and changed the course of history for him forever. Derwin, for a brief period, actually for a few minutes, had physically died at the scene of the accident, and a nurse had come to the scene and resuscitated him. Following this accident, this was actually 3 days before his 26th birthday. Following this accident, Derwin was life-flighted to Fargo Hospital from Minot and spent 3 months in a coma due to traumatic brain and body injuries. When Derwin came out of his coma, due to the severity of the brain damage, he suffered blindness, severe speech impediments, and unable to walk, to feed himself and or support himself or family. For years, Derwin worked through the pain of this loss, having physical therapy, suffering multiple surgeries, seizures, and other bumps and bruises along the way. Derwin, even in tremendous loss, turned his life to one of faith. And Derwin was never afraid to share his love for Jesus.
I can remember one particular night that Derwin had said to me, "Jim, you know, I'm so thankful that God has allowed this accident to happen to me." And I was just a freshman in high school at the time, and I remember I had just helped him to the bathroom and was helping feed him, and I thought to myself, how can anyone be thankful for this? It was really hard for me to comprehend. But it was then that Derwin said to me, "Jim, if I would have died in that accident, I would have went to hell for eternity." It was at that moment that Derwin had my full attention. Derwin went on to explain to me that Jesus had given him a second chance to come back and to let others know that there is life after death, and that Jesus wanted us all to know him and to be born again. Derwin was confident in his faith in Jesus that he had shared with me. He was so confident to the point that he even told me in that same conversation, he said, "Jim, someday you will be a Christian." I'll never forget that. And it was some years later that this became a reality, and I finally understood what he was talking about. "I once was blind, but now I see." With Derwin, it took his physical blindness for him to see what was really true about the spiritual world. Derwin had made his new life in Christ his mission. He would often make bookmarkers with Bible verses on them and give them to others. He wanted to share with others the great faith that he had found in Jesus. Derwin even made a public service announcement about his accident and the dangers of drinking and driving. Derwin would speak at high school assemblies to share his powerful story and to encourage others to drive sober. Derwin spent some time in rehab in Grand Forks, North Dakota, as well as Red Wing, Minnesota, but made his home for the last 20 years here in Devil's Lake. He enjoyed laughter. He had an infectious laugh and a sense of humor like no one else. And as I said earlier, he would often experiment with different food combinations, sometimes even putting Fig Newtons in his coffee and then going digging for gold. He would add fruit juices to his milk. He loved spicy things. He loved horseradish. He loved Tabasco. It was just amazing how he had the ability to make people feel better about their day. And Derwin also had, you know, a great love for his family, for brothers and sisters, nieces and nephews, son and grandsons. They were the joy of his heart. And on a warm summer's day, you could see Derwin enjoying soaking up the sun, sitting out in the front lawn, getting his tan on. And it wasn't uncommon for you to see him there. And whenever you'd ask Derwin, we'd say, "Hey Derwin, how you doing?" To this he would answer, "Anyhow." To summarize the life of Derwin would be to say, amazing faith. Derwin, that amazing faith has carried you your entire life here on earth, and now safely into the arms of Jesus. And I can only imagine what heaven is like, and to be reunited with our loved ones that have gone before us. I'm dedicating this song to you, Derwin.
What my eyes will see when you face
face is before me, I can only imagine.
We see you later. It's not goodbye. But for a moment, we are apart. We look forward to the day when we will all reunite with Jesus. I believe Derwin, his message is the same today that it was for many years. That Derwin would encourage us all, place our hope in the living, eternal God who is Jesus. Scripture reminds us that unless a man be born again, we cannot see the kingdom of God. That would be the message that Derwin would want us to all take away from his life here on earth, to trust in Jesus. You know, it was brought to my attention that Derwin had passed away about 11 o'clock on the 22nd. The very following day would have been a one-year anniversary of my brother Gordy passing. But then it was brought to my attention that this year is a leap year. So because of that, it really was 1 year from the time that Gordy had gone to heaven, that Derwin went. And I just thought that was really amazing to sit back and think about that, and to think about that reunion that took place. The two brothers, again, meeting in the sky, high-fiving each other, Derwin being able to run and see them being able to go fishing and just and love on each other and see each other in eternity. That's an amazing picture to me. But I believe that Jesus wants us all to know that he waits for us in eternity. And it's a gift that he wants us all to freely receive. And so that is my prayer, that everyone within earshot of my voice would place your eternal trust in Jesus Christ, so that we all can be reunited in heaven together. Because to tell you the truth, I can't imagine being in heaven and not seeing every one of you there. And although Derwin was not immune from pain, he lived a life of purpose. That purpose was what sustained him in a powerful way. I mean, think about that. 40 years, once knowing what it's like to see, and then no longer being able to see, and no longer able to take care of yourself, no longer able to feed or provide for your family. But you know, the purpose he had, it sustained him in a powerful way. He made the best of his circumstance, and long-suffering at times, in places of loneliness. But he was using it as a testimony to the hope that he had in Jesus, that one day he would see Jesus face to face. That day has come, Derwin. Your 40-year wait is now upon you. The hymn Amazing Grace says, "I once was blind, but now I see." Derwin can now see heaven and all of those who have gone before us. May the eternal God of peace shine his everlasting love on you as you enjoy his presence and the company of the saints. Jesus answered, "I am the way and the truth and the life, and no one comes to the Father except through me." At this time, I'd like to do another dedication of Derwin, a song I wrote called Memories.
Time. The end of time.
Will you bow your heads with me in prayer? Lord, as we take time out to reflect upon your goodness, God, and the powerful testimony that you gave to our brother Derwin, Lord, in changing his life. Father, we thank you that he's in glory now, Father. He's in a place where there's no more pain, no more suffering, no more anger, no more disease. And Father, now Derwin sees again, and he sees the eternal light, God, that you have given to him. May the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be upon you. May his light guide you and comfort you as we say goodbye to Derwin. We say thank you, Jesus, that because of your great love for mankind, we can all have this eternal hope. And may we all place our trust in his hands. Amen. Service is now ended, and go in peace.
You're gone.